The halal market has emerged as one of the most lucrative and also influential market arenas in the world today. It has become a global symbol of quality assurance and also lifestyle choice. It is most definitely a new market force that should not be overlooked. And Malaysia has attractively positioned itself to be the center of distribution, production and also promotion of halal food. Now, Malaysia's focus on food is a natural progression as food encompasses 60% of the global market for halal products. In our next segment, let's find out more about the potential and also look at how these companies have gained from venturing into the halal food-based industry. Have a look.
Like in most economies, the small and medium enterprises, or SMEs, in Malaysia are seen as the drive for innovation and competition. In Malaysia, the agency that acts as the central point of reference for information and advisory services for all SMEs is SME Corp. SME Corp also plays the role of the national focal point for the overall development of SMEs in Malaysia. On the other hand, the Halal Development Corporation, or HDC, oversees all halal aspects as the new growth sector of the country and continuously looks for ways to enhance halal-related industries. SME Corp and HDC are separate entities, but together they form a formidable team. Meanwhile, the realization of the country's vision to be a leader in the halal industry cannot be achieved without active participation by the private sector. One of the most significant collaboration between the public and private sector is the working agreement made by SME Corp, HDC and Nestle. Find out more about this collaboration in our next interview session.
In this collaboration, Nestle will provide training and guidance to SMEs especially on the industrial best practices such as on halal implementation, production performance, marketing and sales. Participating SMEs will hear it directly from Nestle experts in the respective field. Nestle has signed a memorandum of agreement together with HDC, Halal Industry Development Corporation, and SME Corp, Small Medium Entrepreneurs Corporation, in August 2009, and the purpose of this collaboration promotes the opportunities for the SMEs to explore in the halal business, to help SMEs to produce up to the mark of what is required as halal products, in order for SMEs also to penetrate the global market. In line with the country's aspiration to become the global hub for halal products, Nestle will continue to support in preparing more SMEs to grow into suppliers to the food and beverages industries and eventually to be exporters to the international market. The global halal market is just too big and mostly untapped. Supply is currently not meeting demand. Therefore, this collaboration is vital in propelling SMEs in Malaysia to grow to the demand in order for Malaysia to be the global hub for halal.
The halal food and beverage industry is not without its ups and downs. Nestle is one company that believes it can face any challenges it encounters.
Implementation of halal has come a long way for Nestle Malaysia since the 1970s when Nestle started operation in Malaysia. This is due to mainly social responsibility and sensitivity towards meeting consumer demand. We were in fact instrumental in the introduction of halal certification in 1994, where we were at the forefront to receive the certification from JAKIM. Halal business has a huge potential to grow due to the magnitude of Muslim population in the world of around 1.6 to 1.7 billion and still growing in numbers as well as in awareness on halal. Nestle Malaysia sales in 2009 was ringgit Malaysia 3.7 billion, of which nearly 700 million ringgit Malaysia worth of products were exported. Growth of our business has been steady since halal initiatives already in place even before the era of halal certification.
Welcome back to Halal World, and we have reached the last segment for today's episode. And in this last segment, we'll be elaborating on exporting Malaysia's halal products. Now, we also will touch on elevating the level or standards of locally manufactured or produced products and the requirements needed before entering the international market. Now, if you are a manufacturer and you would like to export your products, then you may find the information provided in this next segment useful for you. So please stay with us. Now, the Malaysian External Trade Development Corporation, or MATRADE, and also HDC, the Halal Development Corporation, will each give their views on issues of the same nature. So please have a look.
The food and beverage industry is growing and is expected to grow even further. One local company that has already been exporting its products to the Middle East, America, South Africa, United Kingdom and Europe is Cart Food. Established in 1988, Cart Food specializes in manufacturing and distribution of a variety of traditional Asian ethnic frozen food, as well as Western food. Find out Cart Food's achievements in our next interview session.
From the beginning, Cart only manufacture products that are strictly and stringently in accordance to halal requirements. And today, actually, you can find Cart's products in all hypermarkets, supermarkets, mini markets. You can find them in hotels, schools, canteen, food outlet, kiosks, and others now. We believe that we are the market leader and that we have a very wide coverage of the market segment for our frozen range of products. As I've mentioned, Cart's from the beginning only manufacture halal products. Once you have established your product process and the quality standards to achieve the halal certification for your products, then you would have the basis to market your products on the premise that your products are of quality and safe, not only to Muslim but to all consumers as well. As a producer, we must have the full confidence in our product that are able to meet international requirements as food safety and quality requirements as well. So by getting your product certified halal, you are ready, putting your product ready for the international market and ready to comply with new standards and international requirements. We will continue to participate in events to promote halal products and to showcase them both locally and in international arena. We aim to expand our market share based on the premise that the product we offer is safe and quality product which is fully compatible with Muslim requirements and also to all consumers as well.
One food company that manufactures a variety of halal food products, including its famous bread, is Silverbird. Silverbird uses only certified halal ingredients recognized by Islamic bodies in the preparation of their products. Silverbird Group Berhad is also classified by the Sharia Advisory Council as a Sharia-compliant securities listed on Bursa Malaysia.
As we understand, Silverbird is one of the major bread manufacturing company. And we have two strong shareholders, Lembaga Tabung Haji and Koperasi Permodalan Felda Berhad. And the acceptance of Silverbird's halal products is shown by the strong growth over the years, and this is also evidenced by the acceleration of sales that we see over the past few years. We have plans to participate in more international exhibitions such as the Gulf Food in Dubai, which is one of the most important food and beverage exhibition in the Middle East. And we are also looking forward to tap into places like Cologne, Germany, where the world's most important food and beverage trade fair in Aduga is held. And this year alone, Silverbird will be participating in Paris, a global food exhibition, providing a full food product offering. The exhibition in Paris is the public trade fair focusing on home cooking and the domestic kitchen. The exhibition ranges from raw products to ready-made food and drinks, kitchen equipment, literature, and food exporting information.
With the intention of building a global halal community, the Halal Industry Development Corporation, HDC's role is to continuously nurture the growth and participation of local businesses into the global halal market.
The question of readiness applies to different markets. While it is easy to make halal products available in the local market, because the standards are not as strict as those in Japan, in Europe, and in the United States. Yeah? So halal alone will not ensure that these companies will be able to penetrate the foreign markets. There's also international certification in the like of HACCP, GMP, and so on. Yeah? So they have to comply with all this, or what I would term as co-branding with this other certification in order to penetrate the consumer market overseas.
That's all the time we have for today, and we really hope that you have benefited from this week's episode that gave you insights on the halal food and beverage industry. Well, thank you very much to the Malaysian Export Exhibition Centre, MEEC. Now, a wide range of products that have been exported are being displayed here from Malaysia, and really, they're truly, truly remarkable and interesting indeed. Now, I wish success for them, success for you, your business, and of course, in everything that you do. A word of wisdom on success by David Brink. Now, he says that a successful person is one that can lay a firm foundation with the bricks others throw at him. Let's just do that. Till I see you again, goodbye everybody. You're watching Halal World.